Every day, hundreds of millions of people battle various types of autoimmune disease. Some 30 years ago, science had few insights into why the immune system starts to attack and destroy a person's own tissues and organs. But the discoveries made by this year's Crafoord Prize Laureates, Christopher Goodnow and David Nemazee, have revolutionized our understanding of how the immune system works.
The laureates are very worthy recipients of the Crafoord Prize in polyarthritis because of their fundamental discoveries in autoimmunity.
The discovery made by Christopher Goodnow and David Nemazee may not only help us to understand disease mechanisms, but also pave the way for development of new forms of therapy that eventually can cure the diseases, or even vaccines that might prevent disorders in the future.
The immune system is very complex and has several lines of defense. There are white blood cells, T cells, and the focus for this year's Crafoord Prize, B cells. B cells come from our bone marrow, where they develop almost infinite combinations of receptors. The B cells then travel to other parts of the body where they can be activated if they recognize harmful viruses or bacteria. Once they are activated, they can trigger other cells to attack the intruders. They also start producing antibodies, which protect us from infections. But in some people, the B cells and the antibodies attack their own tissues instead, destroying joints or internal organs.
Mina första symptom var ifrån mina leder. Jag fick mer och mer ont I lederna. Jag hade svårt att ta mig ur sängen och fick rulla ur sängen för att komma upp. Jag hade svårt att veckla ut fingrarna.
Marie Tuveson Paulsen was 25 when she was diagnosed with lupus, which hundreds of thousands of people are diagnosed with globally every year. Marie's immune system attacked her lungs and then her heart.
Har ett sinne I att försöka hålla humör och glädje uppe. Men det är tufft när man inte ser en vändning utan det fortsätter på fel håll.
For a long time, science had tried to solve the riddle of what caused autoimmune disease. Christopher Goodnow, now at the Garvan Institute of Medical Research in Australia, and David Nemazee at Scripps Research Institute in California, independently of each other, took a new approach. Instead of asking what caused the disease, they asked, why don't we all develop an autoimmune disease?
They were thinking outside the box and tried new ideas.
They have done great work by using very elegant transgenic mouse systems. And this, of course, has very significant insights into our understanding of autoimmune disorders.
The laureates discovered what is now called B-cell tolerance. When B-cells develop in the bone marrow, not all of them are perfect. To remove the faulty ones, a mechanism starts in which defective cells are programmed to destroy themselves through apoptosis. The laureates discovered two new mechanisms that are used if some of the bad cells are left: re-editing, where the immune system alters the combination of receptors, and anergy, that silences B cells with self-reactive receptors. The laureates were able to demonstrate that these mechanisms sometimes fail. This means that faulty B cells can cause an attack on the body's own tissues, leading to autoimmune diseases. Thanks to the laureates' discoveries, doctors like Anders Bengtsson soon felt able to start treating patients with lupus, arthritis, multiple sclerosis, and many other autoimmune diseases with medicines that eradicated B cells.
I'm very happy that the B cell has got so much attention because of the laureates. I've seen my patient getting so much better and getting a better life.
Vad är mina skor?
Idag mår jag väldigt bra. Men jag hoppas ju verkligen på forskningen att det ska revolutionera och till och med kanske man kan bota alltihopa. Så att det är ju egentligen det jag vill och hoppas och tror.
The Crafoord Prize in Polyarthritis for 2025, worth 6 million Swedish krona, is awarded to Christopher Goodnow and David Nemazee. The citation reads, "For the discovery of fundamental mechanisms for B-cell tolerance."
At first I couldn't believe it was true. I still don't believe it was true, but it's slowly sinking in and it's wonderful. One of the influences perhaps for why I originally became so interested in B-cell tolerance was my mother had systemic lupus, an autoimmune disease related to arthritis, and I think that certainly made me think about that problem, a lot more than other problems.
Do you think there will be a cure?
I do. For a while, it was gloom and doom. There's nothing that you thought would work. Now you can see light at the end of the tunnel. And for David and I, it was new ways of genetically engineering mice that for the first time, we weren't going round and round in circles trying to get the answer. The answer was clear as day.
The Crafoord Prize is awarded in partnership between the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and the Crafoord Foundation in Lund, Sweden. The Academy is responsible for selecting the Crafoord Laureates.